Okay, in this question here, we are going to look at this cosine function. And before we begin anything else, we need to factor out our b value. So anytime there's a b value, you always want to factor that out. So I'm going to do x over 3 divided by 1 over 3 is x, plus pi over 3 divided by 1 over 3 is just pi. Okay, so there it is factored out. I can always put it back in to check. So 1/3 of x is x over 3, and 1/3 of pi is pi over 3. So yes, I did that correctly. Okay, let's look at the period. So the period is equal to 2 pi divided by your b value of 1/3. So if I divide by 1/3, I can multiply that by 3, but to be fair, I need to do that to the top. So my period is just 6 pi over 1. Phase shift. The phase shift is your horizontal translation. So your phase shift, remembering horizontal lies, is actually pi units to the left. And your vertical displacement is your d value, but there is none. Nothing added on the outside. So let's look at our mapping notation to determine our minimum coordinate. So x and y is going to be on the outside vertically. I just triple it. And then horizontal lies, I'm stretching it by a factor of 3, and then I am moving it pi units to the left. So I'm stretching it and moving it to the left. So let's look at a sine graph. If we look at just the base sine graph like this in both directions, I have a minimum here and a minimum here. And I'm moving, sorry, we're doing cosine. Let me back up the bus and try cosine this time. So cosine looks like this. And like this. So I have a minimum value on either side. Now I am stretching it and moving it to the left. So I am going to go with this point right here. And that point is at pi and negative 1. So I'm going to run that through the mapping notation. So 3 times pi is 3 pi, take away pi is 2 pi. And then 3 times y is negative 1. So that new minimum point closest to the y-axis would be 2 pi. And negative 3.